Today we will discuss on Tinea saginata, and it is also known beef tapeworm. And side by side we will also discuss on Tinea solium, which is pork tapeworm. As the intermediate host, the pork is very less in number in this region, so there is less infection of Tinea solium. So we will discuss mainly on the Tinea saginata or the beef tapeworm. The definitive host for the beef tapeworm is human, and the intermediate host is cattle. And for the Tinea solium, the intermediate host is the pig. That means the adult worm resides in the human and the larval stage develop in the cattle. Infective form for human is the larva. Larva is also known as cyst sarcus, because the larva is in the cyst form, that is a fluid filled cyst form in which the oncosphere is located. This is called cyst sarcus. In case of the Tinea saginata, it is called the cyst sarcus bovis, and in case of Tinea solium, it is called cyst sarcus cellulosi. And mode of infection in case of human is the ingestion of larva in undercooked beef. Now let us discuss about the life cycle of this Tinea saginata and also the Tinea solium. It uses two hosts to complete its life cycle. The definitive host is the human, and the intermediate host is the pig or cattle. So adult worm lives in the intestine of the human, and it is composed of many segments or proglottids. The gravid or mature proglottids detach from the body of the tinea, and it passes through the anus or stool. And this adult or gravid proglottids has many eggs. So eggs comes into the environment with the feces. And if the cattle or pig takes meal which is contaminated with this feces or eggs, the cattle or pig will be infected. In the pig's intestine, these eggs will hatch out and give rise to the oncosphere. This oncosphere in the intestine burrows the intestinal wall and enters into the bloodstream. And through the bloodstream, it goes to the different parts of the body. So by bloodstream, it will be disseminated in different body parts of the intermediate host of cattle, like skeletal muscle, brain and eyes in many places. In the tissue or skeletal muscle, this oncosphere will give rise to the larva or cyst sarcus. So human will be infected if the flesh or skeletal muscle is ingested as undercooked meat by human, and it through the undercooked meat, the cyst sarcus will enter inside the human intestine, and they will become adult worm by 3 months in the intestine. So the adult worm lives in the intestine of the human body, and the general condition that gives rise by this adult worm is called the tineasis. The Tinea saginata can give rise only the condition tineasis, but in case of the Tinea solium or pig tapeworm, that can be responsible for tineasis and as well as cyst sarcosis. So the presence of adult worm in the human intestine is usually asymptomatic or not that much harmful. It will pass the proglottids occasionally in stool. But in case of presence of larva or cyst sarcosis, that can give rise to many clinical condition or problems in case of patient. Cyst sarcosis is the larval stage of both the parasite, but cyst sarcosis occurs in case of only Tinea solium, and if human ingest the eggs accidentally with contaminated food and drink, then the cyst sarcosis may develop. It doesn't develop from eating the undercooked flesh of the pig, rather from directly ingestion of the eggs, and this cystic sarcosis doesn't develop in case of Tinea saginata. The eggs in the human intestine will give rise to the oncosphere, and this oncosphere will burrow the intestinal wall into the bloodstream. Through the bloodstream, this cystic sarcosis, this oncosphere may disseminate to many organs, especially eyes and brain, where the encysts to form cystic sarcosis. Each cystic sarcosis contains a particular larva. The clinical findings in case of the adult worm, usually most patients are asymptomatic. Some may develop anorexia and diarrhea that may occasionally seen, and some person or carriers may notice the pass of proglottids through the feces. But in case of cystic sarcosis, it is dangerous in case of some person, because it can give clinical features like space occupying lesion, and there may be headache, vomiting, seizure. And this neurocystic sarcosis or NCC is the main cause of acquired seizure in case of human. And the cystic sarcosis in the eye can do retinitis, uveitis. And we know that no cystic sarcosis occur in case of Tinea saginata. So a Labordet diagnosis, we can diagnose the Tinea infection in the laboratory by examination of the stool of the patient. Usually the proglottids are frequently found in comparison to the eggs. Eggs are not regularly found. So proglottids in the stool can be examined under microscope, and sometimes the hematoxylin eosin stain can be used to find out these proglottids. And if we compare the proglottids of Tinea saginata and Tinea solium, the Tinea saginata proglottids will have 15 to 20 uterine, primary uterine branches, and in case of Tinea solium there will be 5 to 10 uterine branches, and the Tinea saginata proglottids a bit longer than the Tinea solium. So these are the differentiating point to identify the particular proglottids in the stool. But eggs of the both species are morphologically similar, and they cannot be used to distinguish one from another. The cystic sarcosis that develops in the tissue, that it can be diagnosed by demonstrating the cyst in the tissue by biopsy, and also by radiology like CT scan. And ELISA or serology can be used to diagnose the antibody against the antigens of different Tinea worms. So there are many methods to identify. So treatment option for this Tinea infection is, when there is only adult worm in the intestine, we can use praziquantel for the intestinal worm, and this is very, very effective against the adult worm. And in case of larval stage or cystic sarcosis or tissue cystic sarcosis in the tissue, we can use praziquantel and as well as albendazole. And sometimes surgical excision may be necessary for removal of the cyst from the specific tissue. So there are measures to be taken to prevent this Tinea infection. And the main way of preventing is to cooking the beef adequately before consumption. Sometimes people usually take beef with inadequate cooking, like different form, like grills or like that. And this can be a source of the larval stage of the parasite, and people can be infected. So cooking adequately is very important, and also disposing waste properly, human waste properly, so that cattle cannot consume the human feces.